Hi guys, from the apartment. Hooray for starting the video in the new apartment. I haven't shown off the current status of the apartment yet, which I'm actually gonna try to do a little bit later. But today, I'm actually planning to go meet up with my brother Dennis to do some rock climbing because Dennis loves rock climbing and he's actually moving to Atlanta here in a few weeks. So I think today may be the last time that I get to hang out with him and go do that with him because he just loves rock climbing. Like, theme parks to me is rock climbing to Dennis, so I definitely want to go make it out one more time just to go hang out with him. I'm gonna bring my GoPro and do some filming there, maybe just kind of like do some errands today. I don't know, I finally have a day off because I've been editing this giant investment course for my brother's company, and then right after that I had to edit all of my New York stuff, and then I had to catch up on all my theme park stuff after that. So I'm finally catching back up with myself and preparing for my family coming down in a few days, actually, because we're going to be staying at the Polynesian Resort, which is, again, incredible. So I have a few days here just to kind of coast a little bit to get some apartment stuff done to really just kind of catch up with myself on just everything. But right now, I'm going to go hop in the car and then go meet up with Dennis for some rock climbing. All right, so we made it to the rock climbing gym. Here's Dennis. Hey, buddy. How you doing? This could be the last time that we rock climb together. Isn't that kind of sad?
It's probably gonna be my last time rock climbing in Orlando too.
Today's gonna be your last day in Orlando rock climbing?
No, I'm gonna move in a week and hanging out with you all next week, so.
Yeah, but we're gonna be staying at the Polynesian though. It's kind of fun, right?
It's a great game.
Nice. So it's kind of quiet in here comparatively to how I've seen it. They're also changing out the bouldering routes over there. So there's only the routes right there and on the other side, and then there's top roping over here, and I love myself some top roping, you know that, right? All right, we're also here with Brenton, but I'm gonna go and switch over to the GoPro now to get some cool GoPro footage.
All right, so we're over here by the bouldering wall. You can see all the pieces that they're using to recreate a new set of routes over here. So we pretty much have this whole thing to ourselves. It's pretty exciting, right, Dennis? I think I'm gonna go over here and do this green one to start it off.
I did like a weird crossover at the top.
Yeah, you gotta watch out what you're doing.
Yeah.
That'll make it harder.
We did a few routes over there, and now we're over here. I think I'm gonna try this orange one. Okay.
Yep. There you go.
Did a pivot here?
Dang, Dennis is gonna show me how it's done. It's all about where you move your feet. Dang. Embarrassing me just like that. Really makes it look so easy. This is a weird route.
This is painful. Yeah, I don't know how to finish it.
It took all the way up there? Yeah.
Yep.
Stay tight, come on.
Yeah,
yes,
come on, come on.
Sick.
Finish it
nice.
Out.
Come on,
hold it.
Come on.
It's a
joke.
I gotta reach it.
You got it.
Oh, so close.
Yeah, I can't get over it. Like, I wanna go for it.
dang, Dennis. You guys are embarrassing me.
It's okay.
So we were just back there. There's some more bouldering back here, but this is a lot of top roping roots over here. And they're still working on putting together the new roots over here. It's really cool to see them do this and put these all together. I think we're gonna do a little bit more bouldering over here and then maybe do some top roping over here. I'm gonna try this white one right here because it's a V0, which means it should be pretty easy.
Okay.
Yeah, this is really, really easy. Okay. Hi. All right, Dennis is doing this red one now. Dennis is doing the purple route now, which he says takes a lot of muscle. So I think after this we're gonna go top roping. Whoa. How often do you come rock climbing?
Too much!
All right, so we have our harnesses on here. Dennis is putting his on right now, and he's going to belay me down at this wall right here, the purple route. We are now top roping, and I'm so excited. This is my favorite part of rock climbing.
All right,
here we go. Hopefully I can do this pretty quickly. I feel like I've been doing a pretty dismal job so far. These handholds are a little bit small.
Can you get me tight?
Climbing fast.
I am climbing fast. This is a lot of fun. I definitely prefer top roping to bouldering, personally. Yeah. Just because it's a lot easier than clinging to the side of a wall. Oh, I'm already done. Yay. Hi, Dennis. All right, so I just did purple, and I think now I'm gonna do the green one here. Looks a little bit weird, but it looks pretty easy. Are you ready? Cool. This is interesting. Okay. It's like I'm like climbing a coral reef or something. All done. Yay. All right, now we are switching it up. I'm gonna be the one doing the rappelling, and Dennis is gonna be the one climbing. He's gonna do this black route right here. Did you tie the knot right? Looks pretty good. Did I do this right?
It's important to do that. There you go.
Yes.
All right, I'm supposed to narrate my experience with, it's what Roy told me to do, but I'm afraid I'm gonna finish too fast to narrate it. I'm just searching out what I wanna do. I'm gonna put that foot right there because I like that. You know, 5/6 are kind of like climbing a ladder. Not really exhausting at all compared to bouldering. Finish is right there, I'm just gonna right to it. Alright, so we switched ropes. Now Dennis is gonna be the yellow one. Mm-hmm. Right, Dennis?
Yep.
What difficulty is this? 5/7, so it's a little bit harder than the one you just did?
Yeah, but it's... Yeah, it's still kind of warm up for me.
Yeah, Roy would hate this one.
There we go. Oh, these all suck. There we go.
These are all just like very smooth. There we go. That's better. I think Roy is giving a biased view of bouldering. I like bouldering because it's more strength-based, whereas top roping is more endurance-based. It's like a completely different sport. There's Roy down there.
All right, so back on this camera for just a second because Dennis right here, hi Dennis, he had a pretty cool idea. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna film on this and on this for a couple routes over here. So I'm gonna like slate it for both this and this at the same time, and I can actually cut back and forth between like a POV view and then an on the ground view. I think that's a pretty good idea. So I'm gonna go do one of these over here, I think, and record on this, and then Britton's gonna film it while Dennis belays.
All right, so I have to slate this so they can sync up later when it comes to like audio and stuff.
What do you?
I'm gonna just clap.
Okay. Ready?
There we go.
Take one.
All right, you ready, Dennis?
Am I allowed to talk?
No. No reason, I just, I hate hearing your voice.
No, not at all. I'm choosing yellow because it's pretty easy. Hi. Let's see, it's getting a little bit harder though as I get to the top. Uh-oh. Right. This one's a little bit more challenging than I thought it would be. Woo! But I'm almost there. Oh, I made it. I did it.
All right, so now Britton is doing this yellow one over here. It's a completely vertical wall. We were over here doing these, and I did those over there. This is exciting. This one's really, really difficult, right, Dennis?
Yep. It's a 5'10". I've only gotten one 5'10".
A 5'10"? Look at those tiny little nubs.
Nice. It's a completely different kind of climbing, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's not like the harder stuff, because it's more like a Rubik's Cube that you have to solve.
It looks really, really hard.
So I think the next thing you're going to have to do is what's called the crux of the route, which is the hardest part.
Yeah.
Those three bolts to the left. It's either going to be that or after that next big hold up there.
Wow. How is this guy so good, Dennis?
He's got really good body control. Helps a lot to know which ways to point your hips, angle your foot. He's got it now. He's going free.
I don't believe it, man.
I told you you'd do it.
Wow.
Come on, Brent, can tell you you can't do something.
Those new routes are really coming along well. I think Dennis said he wants to do the white route right over here on this wall, which that looks pretty intense. I'm going to give the GoPro to Dennis, and then I'm going to film him on this. So we'll all have done a route with a GoPro, POV, and then a route from the ground. This route is perfect for Dennis because he does not like heights. And this is one of the tallest, highest routes in the entire building.
So one thing I did when I was climbing, I bumped my, my against
your head?
I bumped the GoPro against the wall a lot when I was climbing.
Oh, that's fine. I think it withstand that.
Nice day. Yeah, lean to your right.
You made it over this area right here. Now it's smooth sailing. If you can make it all the way to the top.
Actually, that middle section with the big holes a little far apart.
Yeah. Right there?
Yeah. A little, about 5 feet above his head.
Yeah.
Sorry, I can't provide woody commentary right now.
He's doing so good. I had to lay down on the ground, literally, just to make sure that I could get the angle because it's so high up. And then this wall, particularly, actually slants backward.
That's far. Oh man. Oh. That's hard. All right, so we are back on the GoPro now. Hi, Dennis.
Hello.
And now I'm gonna be doing this yellow one over here. I don't think I've ever done anything on this wall. You just did the white one all the way up there, and that was pretty impressive, right? Mm-hmm. Proud of yourself? All right, let's do it.
Okay,
here we go. Oh, this is very easy. Okay, good. I'm getting pretty tired, so the easier the better for me, honestly.
This may be easy, but it's still
pretty high up here comparatively to the other side of the gym, I'm pretty sure. So you gotta watch how I cross over my hands. I have to follow the route that the wall wants me to take if I want to be successful. All right. Whew. I did it. I am pretty high off the ground. Hey, Dennis. All right, heading down.
So I just did this yellow one right here, which was pretty easy. Now Dennis wants to come do one of these right over here. And then after he does that, I'm gonna do one of these over here. I think this yellow one right here, which is also pretty easy because I'm just kind of feeling it today. And that may be my last run of the day.
All right, so Dennis is doing this green one right over here. Are you excited, Dennis?
Yep. Should be fun.
You feel confident?
Yeah, it looks easier than the white one. This is more technical than strength-based, I think.
Oh, it's a bad one.
Oh, that's why. That's where I'm supposed to go.
Yeah, yeah. This is difficult. Getting around that was annoying.
So Dennis just did this green route all the way up to the top, which was a 5.9, right?
Mm-hmm.
You tired?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna end the day on this yellow one, which is a 5.7, which looks pretty easy, but I don't know, we'll see. Could surprise me. All right, here we go, last route of the day. Maybe ever, but maybe not. I may come back to this rock climbing gym in the future. It's been fun the times that I've been here. Maybe Dennis will come back from Atlanta and we'll go rock climbing again, right?
All right.
Here, buddy.
So that route was just all the way over there, and then I think Dennis's last route's gonna be this awkward black one right here, and then after this I think we're gonna head out.
Thanks, Roy.
That's why you have to keep your hand on the rope.
So you gotta keep that tighter.
What do you mean? It's very tight.
This? No.
If you didn't see that, Dennis just fell off the wall and completely went horizontal, like he was laying on a bed.
But I'm still fine. I bet that's when you wish you had your other camera filming, huh?
Yeah.
There we go. I learned from my mistakes last time. Oh man, sorry if I scraped the camera a lot. This one had to be a lot closer to the wall. Dang it. There's the big nipple. Ah, jeez. Oh, that hurt my hip. Ow. Oh, this sucks. Oh. Well, I'm sitting on the nipple now.
Sit on the nipple.
I am.
down.
No. Oh, jeez.
That was impressive, dude.
That felt really rewarding. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So right now, Dennis is just holding himself here right like this because this is part of his end of workout regimen. Woo! That looked kind of hard. So he has to follow this right here. He has to do pull-ups. He has to hang. Pretty much just a lot of pull-ups. And this is kind of over here in the corner next to this top roping wall. We're all done climbing, I think, for the day.
So this is called a hangboard. It's one of the best ways to train climbing. You have all your different holds on it. You have jugs up here. You have slopers right here. You have like 2-finger pockets and 3-finger pockets. Then you have large edges, medium edges, and small edges.
Mm-hmm.
Each of these you can only fit a certain amount of your fingers in. Small edges is about like that much. That was the one I was hanging from. Large edges, it's about to there. So it's different degrees of difficulty. And they have like a workout sheet here. I'm working on strength so I can get stronger, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But then there's other ones where it's a lot more like hangs. Like this one is like a 15-second hang with 3 shrugs on a 3-finger pocket. And I don't want to do that. So
nope.
That's why I'm doing pull-ups instead.
Nice. So this is what we're going to do? Or yeah. This is what Dennis is going to do? I am not going to do this.
Next is 3 pull-ups on jugs.
Yeah, so he's going to start doing pull-ups now. Dennis is so insanely strong, putting me into an embarrassing fit. Why are you so much stronger than me, Dennis?
Because I climb twice every week.
Every big brother awaits the day that his younger brother surpasses him in mental and physical prowess, right? All right, so after this, I think we're gonna go back to your place and you're gonna make me some lunch, right? Mm-hmm. And then I'm gonna head out.
Yep.
Hi, so I am back home in my apartment. I'm sorry about the jump cut there. It's actually the day after I went climbing with Dennis. I went climbing with Dennis yesterday, so it's kind of a time jump as well. And kind of what happened with that is I went climbing with Dennis, which is probably going to be my last time doing rock climbing with him, at least for like a long time, because he is moving from Orlando, which I'm pretty sad about. And then I went back to his apartment, and him and Brenton actually made me some lunch. They made me some delicious ramen.
So we're back at Dennis's apartment right now, and look what Dennis and Brenton just cooked up for me. What is this, Dennis?
This is ramen.
Ramen, all right.
Not it
looks
ramen.
Absolutely delicious. Look at all this. Got some soft-boiled eggs there, got some scallions and ginger. And what is this, Dennis? The meat?
Roasted pork.
Yeah.
Roasted pork.
Chashu pork.
Awesome, and some seaweed here. This looks awesome. And that kind of just put me straight into a food coma because it was so good. And so I hung out there for a little bit, and then I ran some errands, then I came back home, and then I wanted to kind of show off my apartment, but it kind of wasn't where I wanted it to be before I showed it off, so I tried to organize things and put things away, and then last night I actually had a Memorial Weekend barbecue that I went to hang out with a couple of my friends, so I just kind of stopped filming yesterday, but now here I am, I'm back, just after kind of a weird jump cut, so I do want to show off my apartment, because I've been wanting to kind of give a little bit of an update in more than one way. So I'm gonna go ahead and kind of flip the camera around and just give a quick tour of at least like the main living room and then kind of the back bedroom, because there are some rooms that I'm still kind of working on that I kind of had to move a lot of stuff to so I could kind of clean up this area. So, you know, like the spare bedroom's kind of not where I want it to be, as well as like the back bathroom and the back closet kind of situations. I'll kind of show you and I'll fill you in. So this is the current status of the kitchen, and this is by no means completed. This is just kind of where everything's kind of ended up. I don't know if these are going to stay here, but for the most part, we have our mugs right there above the kitchen sink, and I put all of my Mickey hats up there, kind of like how I did at the other apartment. Got a lot of stuff on the fridge here, kind of tried to kind of tone it down just a little bit from what it was before. Have our alcohols and whatnot up there.
And so yeah, that's kind of the kitchen, and I cleaned it up just a little bit. I really love this island right here. This has been my best friend here, but I'm pretty proud of it. I definitely like it. The space is very, very, very awesome. This is Farley's situation here. This is my trash can. If you guys remember, I went to IKEA to return this, and there was no dent in it, so it's a good-looking trash can. It's just a little bit on the small side, but that kind of just makes me take it out quicker, so, you know, the trash doesn't smell as bad. Now I'm turning into the living room for the grand reveal of this. There's really not much going on in here. Kind of the biggest things have been these big bad boys right here, because I've been trying to sell these on Craigslist, and I've even resorted to giving them away. I put them on there as free if somebody wanted to come pick them up, and that's a whole other kind of thing. I've been having a lot of issues with Craigslist and people falling through kind of nonstop, so that's kind of aggravating for those. But everything else in here is pretty much just, it's a mess, but it's kind of an organized mess right here. What I ended up doing over here and over here is kind of a little personal project. Brennan had these white bookshelves, and what I did is I took the back off the back of the bookshelf there so that it would kind of be a little bit more like muted against the wall instead of just having these really white bookshelves in the corner. And that was probably not the best idea, because the back is kind of what held it together. So when I took the back off and started putting things on it, it started doing this whole thing. So I had to go to the store 2 or 3 times to get very specific metal braces, and I had to brace it at very particular pressure points in these bookshelves, because it's a very, very, very cheap bookshelf that I made even more cheap by taking the back off of it. So over there are books and games that you can kind of see sort of organized over there. And then over here, this is going to be like our knickknack shelf for things that are kind of significant or important to us, like my wand collection, our little Disneyland 60th figurine, and just kind of any other random assortments of things. So this is just kind of the living room, and we've just been kind of really hacking away at this ever so slowly. So this is going to be a major work in progress. This probably won't stay here. We'll figure it out. This is all like from my birthday. So my birthday was a couple days ago, and what Brennan actually got me for my birthday is something I'm so, so excited to show off right here. This is Newt Scamander's wand from Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. So I just kind of have a new wand to add to my collection, and I'm so obsessed with this. This is so, so cool. And then she also got me something that's also super duper cool. It's this Harry Potter Character Vault book, and it's this hardback book that just kind of shows off a lot of cool things about characters, behind the scenes information about filming and character choices, and just all sorts of really, 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 really cool stuff. And I've already started delving into that, and it is just so, so thorough and interesting. This is all just kind of like fun stuff, because the other day, Brennan and I went to breakfast, and I was telling her about when I was younger, my mom would kind of, you know, do the cheesy birthday celebration where she would get like a bunch of stuff from the dollar store, and she'd get just a lot of random toys and trinkets and fun stuff and give it to me. And then I came home from work, and she like had this whole spread over here, with a whole like tablecloth and everything. She got me a little cake, she got me some watermelon and birthday candles and stuff, and it was just so sweet. This is from Game of Thrones, because we've been watching Game of Thrones recently. These are our magic bands, because we are staying at the Polynesian in just a couple days, and I'm so excited. So yeah, so everything in here is just a complete, like, will it stay here? Will it not stay here? Will I ever get rid of these? I hope so, because I've been trying. Just today, I've had 5 people say that they were gonna come pick it up, and they all fell through. They all said that they were showing up, or they were coming, or they were on their way, and then they canceled at the last second, which kind of stinks. So this is the living room, and I put up those blinds and stuff over there too, or those drapes, whatever you want to call them. I'm pretty proud of it. And then we're moving into the hallway here now. Put up a bunch of these cool Universal Attractions posters, so I'm pretty proud of that. I, you know, got my measuring tape out there, and I made sure that everything was exactly equidistant from everything else. So this is the bedroom back in here. And we got a new bedspread here. I don't know if I ever showed that we had this dresser, that we bought this dresser from IKEA, and I assembled it and stuff. And I also assembled this bed frame over here. And then we got these 2 corner end tables with these little lights on them. And
This is kind of a funny story because Farley's been keeping us up at night, like really, really bad. He's been waking us up at like 5 a.m. every single night. So Brennan actually got those for my birthday from the dollar store as well. And I said, we should just keep it on our bedside table. And if like Farley starts meowing, we should just like shoot a warning shot in the air and then maybe he'll hush, but we'll see. The back porch is still looking pretty good. We still have these plants that we bought a little bit ago and they're doing pretty good. Still got a nice view out there and a giant balcony that we still don't know what we're gonna do with all the space. But this is our bedroom. Very, very bland. Nothing on the walls yet or anything like that. But I don't know. I'm pretty proud of the current status back here. So now I'm heading back out to the main area here. And it's so super blurry. There we go.
So that wasn't supposed to be a full apartment tour. It was just supposed to be a quick status update on the apartment and what it looks like, but you guys know how I like to embellish things, and I embellished so much that Brennan came home. So hi, Brennan.
Hi.
Get on in here. So I wanted to also update you guys on the status of our neighbors downstairs, because if you watched the previous apartment video, then you know we don't have the best neighbors downstairs at all, because they, I guess, accused us of being very loud and obnoxious when we were just kind of living in the apartment, walking around, doing dishes, watching TV. And the other night we were walking around the lake outside and I noticed that everything that was previously on their balcony was gone, which means they moved out. Well, that didn't mean that they moved out. I actually came upstairs and I snooped on the apartment website and I checked the apartment listings and their apartment was listed as available. So they are gone. I don't really know the status of how they ended up leaving or what happened with that. I expected the apartment to be on their side about us being loud and then they weren't, and then they were like, well, we're not gonna deal with this and we're gonna leave, or if the apartment kicked them out, or just kind of what happened. I don't know.
I just want it to be a chapter that we are.
It's over, they're gone. The apartment beneath us is empty.
Yeah.
And I hate that it ended up like this. You know, well, I like it because it gives me a little bit of closure that I really think I wanted, but now I'm going to be perpetually, you know, aware of how loud we are. Even with nobody beneath us, I'm still like kind of tiptoeing around the apartment, which is probably, you know, and like I wouldn't have minded doing that in the first place if they weren't so aggressive about it. And I think that's the thing. But that's the update with that, I guess, is that our neighbors are gone and that chapter is closed, and hopefully the people that move in next are gonna be okay with footsteps, right?
But best be sure, Roy is checking that website. Updates.
Yeah. Obsessed. I just want to see when they move in and all that. But so I guess that's kind of it for the apartment update. But there is something else that we're going to be doing tonight. We are going to go see the Animatronicans.
Yeah!
If you guys have been watching this for like a year or so, we watched the Animatronicans last year, which is a really, really cool, creative theme park show that's, it's like R-rated for the most part, but it's very creative and hilarious dialogue and interactions. It's these Disney animatronics that kind of come together to have a cultural conversation, and it's hilarious.
It's very funny, very raunchy, very R-rated, and yeah. I love it.
The show's at 10:45 though, so yeah. It's very late, and you open at work tomorrow, so yeah. You're gonna have a great night tonight, but it's totally worth it, I think, because it's so much fun. Mm-hmm. It's at the French Festival, so we're gonna have some dinner. Right now you have some nuggets in the stove, and we're gonna eat those.
And then ooh, what an update! We're having chicken nuggets!
And then we're gonna go to the Animatronicans. Alright, see you soon. Alright, hello again.
Hi.
So we've changed clothes and spruced up and had our chicken nuggets, and we've made it to the Fringe Festival, which is right behind us. So we're here to see the Animatronicans, which is a show that we already talked about, and it starts in about an hour. So we have that amount of time just to walk around and see what there is to do and see here.
Yeah.
And make our way over to the theater. I think we have to get ourselves a button. We have to pick up our tickets. We have a lot of stuff to do.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it. All right, so we are officially walking around the Fringe Festival right now. There's a lot of cool booths for food and drink around here. So we're just trying to find our venue, I think, right now, just to make sure that we have our tickets, and then maybe we can come back and kind of explore and check out some of these booths for maybe some food or some drinks, or just kind of see what's up. So the festival area is right over there with all the food and drinks and live performers, and we're over here at our venue area, the Museum of Modern Art, for
the Animatronicans.
Yes, so we have to go inside and we're gonna get our tickets and maybe our Fringe button, I think. We're kind of figuring this out as we go, but we're having fun. All right, so the museum is back over there. We have our tickets right here, as well as our buttons.
right there. There's Vernon over there. We're gonna kind of mosey around over here, the festival area, before we have to head back probably in like half an hour or so. So back over in the festival area, there's this really cool board that says, "Before I die," and then everybody writes something on here that they want to do before they die. And there's a little spot over here where there's some room to add on what we want to do before we die. So we grab some chalk and we're gonna contribute. So we walked over there for a bit, and right now we're getting ourselves some little mini donuts. I'm getting this right here, the cookies and cream. Because here it is, cookies and cream, although the Nutella also looks really good. Look at all these little donuts. And here they are, the cookies and cream mini donuts. I also got us some Kool-Aid jammers because we were feeling pretty parched, right? So we're gonna eat these and drink these and then head over to the venue for our show for Animatronicans, which starts in about 20 minutes. Are you feeding this to me? That is so good. Also, if you're curious what we wrote on the wall over there, Brenna basically said that she wants to be a CEO. And then I said, I want to have a good story, which I think it's what it's all about, right? So we made it back over to the Museum of Art, but now there's a pretty long line forming outside for the Animatronicans, but we did get our tickets scanned, we got our brochures for the show. This is what we're here to see, the Animatronicans, and I'm so excited. Alright, here we go, heading into the theater. There's a couple living hedges over here, that's interesting. And here we are inside the theater for the Animatronicans. The show's gonna start in about 10 minutes or so, I'm so excited. See you guys right after the show. All right, so we made it back home to our apartment. It's a little bit after midnight right now. It took about 45 minutes to get there, 45 minutes to get back. It was kind of a drive, but it was really, really worth it. We'd never been to the Fringe Festival before, and I've heard a lot about it, but never gotten to actually experience it. And now that I have, I want to actually experience it more, hopefully, in the future. We have these buttons, which kind of, I think, was admittance to the Fringe Festival, and you can buy specific tickets to the shows. And we saw the Animatronicans, which is, again, a show that we saw. You're holding it upside down. It's a show that we saw last year, and it was just so much fun, and we've already talked about this. And what did you think of the show this year?
I loved it. It's our second year seeing it, and it's honestly just, like, for the theme park community, or honestly even not, like, it's perfect. It's the right kind of humor for if you're into theme parks, and it's the raunchy humor that you really want to get out of the theme parks too. Yeah. So
it's definitely directed towards theme park people, mm-hmm. like for sure, but they threw in some other elements of the show that made it kind of fun for everybody. And I do want to thank Jeff Jones because he played the character Dreamfinder, and I think he watches these videos for some reason. So Jeff, if you're out there, thank you so much for just kind of what you did, the show that you put on. It was absolutely fantastic, and it was because of him that we actually were able to go tonight, because it was a sold out show, and he contacted me and we worked out a couple tickets that I could buy, so we were able to see it tonight, and I'm so happy because we wouldn't have been able to otherwise. And it's just our favorite show that we've seen, and we don't really see many shows, but I'm glad that we saw this one. It mm-hmm. was just
after we saw it last year and we found out that it was coming, or that the next installment was coming back, we were like, we have to see it.
Mm-hmm. And I really hope it kind of continues on for, mm-hmm. you know, years to come, honestly, because it's such a vast, I think, plethora amount of information and things you could do to make a show like that entertaining and fun and relatable. And I know that they could do an incredible job with it. They had a lot more actors this year than they had last year, and we never saw it before last year, but I hope we can kind of continue to see it if they keep doing it, which I hope that they do. So thank you guys for coming along with us.
Yeah.
In this video was kind of all over the place, probably going to be a little bit on the longer side. Sorry about that. Kind of mashing in a bunch of different things into one.
But what video does he not say that in?
That is true. So the next video you're probably going to see is my family's trip to the Polynesian. So that's going to be super exciting. Up. Yeah. But shoot, yeah. What a fun experience climbing with Dennis and then showing off the apartment and then going to the Fringe Festival for the Animatronicans. So I'll see you guys soon. Have a good night, or a good day, whenever you watch this, and goodbye.
Bye.